Alright. Just. I'm,
So, like, when you kind of find something like this,
fuck. Alright. Heck. Nah, alright. Fuck. Alright, yeah, like I was saying before, I'm running some errands now, and Ah, fuck.
They like their normal price is really good.
Moby Dick. Moby Dick. Moby Dick. Moby Dick. Moby Dick. Moby Dick. Right. Fuck. Shit. Anyway, I was gonna relay a message. I was gonna relay a message earlier, but I got busy. Moby Dick. Moby Dick. All right. No. So. Hill. This time, doing this, this quick post, just to say that, whatever it is that I said in the previous video, so I'm out here. Anyway, I was gonna tell a story. Earlier, because first I was gonna write it down, but it's gonna take too long, so I don't know. Which I still am doing, but I don't know. I thought. Fuck. Anyway, I thought it'd be right. I thought it'd be cool to do one where I say it orally because. Fuck. They are some of my favorite. Traditional tales. Oh wait, I mean, in the bardic tradition. Do so. And basically, because anyway, shit. And I'm gonna finish that other story later when we get back to the place. But I'm only doing this video now just to say this story that just happened now. As I was walking down the street just now, and tell me why this lady walked by and I got a huge whiff of her aroma that was just like perfume, and my nostrils inhaled it, and it went to my gut, and it just started making my stomach churl and curl. It's like, what are these artificial fragrances that, you know, these ladies are coming up with love potions now? And fragrant aromas to befuddle the mind. And mask their true scent for attraction. No. But for real, that's how it would go. Imagine some alien strain that was just floating through space, and it just came to Earth somehow, and it's in this chemical format, and when it penetrates the organism's vitals, its nerve system, it just takes it over and animates its own perception through its physiology. Truly alien. And it'll be designed by Nazi chemists from way back in the 1930s. Chemical warfare. You'll never even know. They drop it, you won't even know. Like, when it hits you, your teammates are already trying to revive you and resuscitate you. Like, when it lands, immediately, instantly, there's no deactivating it. And it just takes you over, and you die, and it does it. It latches on to your consciousness like a string with the loop, like you're threading yarn, and it catches you by the hook and just strings you up and they already know, like, it takes over your nervous system, and then you get briefed on it beforehand, so it's like, be aware of this nerve toxin. But when you actually get hit by it, there's no distinguishing anything from anything else. Like, you know, like it's just bizarre. Imagine a crazy Nazi chemical that was developed circa World War I era. That just causes absolutely bizarre thought processes, and how it manages to do that through your brain and its physiology. Look, hypothetically, I would imagine that, say, during the Nazi era Germany, what kind of foul, sinister means do you think some organization would employ to wipe out certain bloodlines from history? What crude and cruel methods would it use to food for thought. Can we get that the three jumbo meatball sub with cheese shoveled down your shoot hole, down your pie hole? Down your chute. Yeah, that'll get him. Down your pie hole. Down your chute. Three jumbo meatball sub with cheese delivered right down your chute hole. 3, Jumbo Meatball Hero, Meatball Hero, Meatball Hero, Meatball Hero, Meatball Hero. That makes sense. Moby Dick, Moby Dick, Moby Dick, Moby Dick. Fuck. Fuck. Afro. Mata, 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 mata